Happy Wednesday! Fantabulous day all the way through. I am in search of another place of employment. And weirdly, today, I scheduled for a specific time for a phone interview. And I work in drug and alcohol, and one of the clients had issues via drugs being confiscated and things like that, and I was unable to participate on the phone interview. And although the first woman that I had spoken with originally and made the appointment with, she was okay with it. She understood, she knew the line of work that I'm in, and I mean the epidemic across the country. You know, heroin is like insane. And the country, not the country, the county that I live in is one of the highest in the country as far as the heroin epidemic. But I'm assuming the man that was on the phone as well to do a piece of my interview, maybe he was her boss, which is ultimately would be my boss too. You can tell he was like very perturbed. And I asked if we could reschedule for maybe like another two hours or maybe tomorrow. He had such an attitude, you felt it even through the phone, even though he was saying, oh, well, we can reschedule another time and, you know, Jody can email you or call you. But I already knew then that he was over it. Like, I was wasting his time. And I even said, well, you know, we can't predict when someone's going to relapse and overdose. And I'm so glad that you understand, especially since the job that I applied for and you're calling me about is about, you know, family unification and supporting people in recovery. It was like a professional jab, so to speak. But even when I hung up, I knew that they were not going to, not her, more so him, was not going to call to reschedule. And I was okay with that. Weirdly, I don't know if I'm just growing, like yay me, or yeah, I'm gonna give myself credit, I'm growing. So I started to make a few stops today, but I said I am just exhausted. I'm always ripping and running. I can never just go home, like never. When I say never, I mean like never. Get tired of getting home late in the evening. So today I just went home. I didn't make one single stop. I went straight home. And as I was pulling in, I got a call from this one job that I really, really want. It's close to home, and the interview is Monday, this Monday. So be praying for me. So excited. Called my sister. I told Jared about it, told some of my girlfriends, and like I need the prayer warriors to step it up. But I've also calmed my nerves and prayed and declared that the job is for me. We're just waiting for the formalities to happen, that's all. To the point on the phone with the lady, I said, just hire me already. Like, let's just get this over with. Just hire me. And she giggled about it. Like, somebody go. So yeah. So say a prayer for me. Greatly, greatly appreciate it. So the lesson in this is, you won't know actually that you've grown in certain areas unless a situation happened and you see your behavior through the situation. Because the old me, you know, I would have stayed professional on the phone, but hung up with an attitude and trying to contemplate why couldn't the hiring manager understand you're hiring me to work with families in drug and alcohol, but I'm currently working in drug and alcohol and someone was confiscated with drugs and we're dealing with overdoses. But when it's a God thing, things don't add up. They don't. And you just have to wait to see the manifestation and see how God's hand move. And that stress about it. I don't feel entitled, but I know I only want what God has for me. So I was just elated about that little quick praise report. And I want to share. That's all. Love you guys. God bless. Bye-bye.